Yo, what's going on? What's going on? Hey, it's your boy Skills. How y'all doing? All right, what's up? Okay, name's Willie Jefferson Jr. I cover video games at the Houston Chronicle. It is a Hearst newspaper located in Houston, Texas, one of the biggest newspapers in the United States. Welcome. All right, so this is what came earlier. If you were keeping score, we got Saban's Power Rangers Super Samurai for the Kinect. All right. So we got that in, all right. We also, I got a couple Black Friday specials on 3D glasses. They normally retail for $30. They had them for $20, so that's a little bit of a deal. All right, Club Nintendo Platinum Playing Cards. I ordered one, and two showed up. Nice, all right. And we received Bethesda Holiday Card. Happy Holidays. From Bethesda, and you got Corvo on there doing his thing. So, and you, of course, you have the, what is that, Vault Boy? Yeah, Bethesda. All right, so that's what came. All right, now, let me be clear. All right, real talk. Okay. So much to talk about, but this is one thing that I just want to, be real with y'all on and share. Okay, so a lot of y'all, if you're not in a relationship, one day you probably will be. One day you may get married. You know, you may find the love of your life. You may have kids. I don't care if you're a man or woman, boy or girl right now. But more than likely, the odds are actually in your favor that you'll find someone that, you know, hopefully you'll make a commitment to that you want to spend the rest of your life with. Okay, with all that said, I am married. I've been married for nearly 11 years. I have two beautiful children. But there was I made a lot of mistakes. No one's perfect. But one thing that I really wish I would have been encouraged to do is, you're going to laugh when I say this, all right? Wait. Wait? What do you mean wait? I'm talking about waiting before you get busy, before you get it crunk, before you hit it. Okay, now I know you're probably saying, Skills, man, what you talking about, dude? Awkward. Okay, I am married. I have children. So, I get busy. Often. Okay, it's that's a benefit of being married. And especially because I'm a Christian, the Bible says marriage is honorable and all, and the bed undefiled. Okay? If you read the Song of Solomon, it's a book located in the Old Testament of the Bible, and it talks about sexual love. Now, a lot of people, they equate the book, the Song of Solomon, to Jesus and his bride, the church, which he's coming back for eventually, according to the Christian faith. But the thing is, if you read that book, it's very, very sexually explicit. Let me tell you how explicit it is. If you made it into a video now, it would have a quadruple X rating. Okay? I mean, you think, you know, Deep Throat, you think, you know, pornos today were absolutely no joke. You make the Song of Solomon, you know, into a modern day video, and wow, but it's married love, and within the confines of a marriage, sex is absolutely beautiful. You can use it to procreate, you know, like I said, I have two children. You can use it for pleasure, you know, pleasuring your spouse. I mean, really just getting it crunk, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that within the confines of a marriage. But if it's not, if you're getting your creep on, and you know what? I wasn't a virgin when I got married. I had made a mistake, and I slept with a young lady twice. But after that, you know, and I was 18 when I lost my virginity. But here's the thing. I was like, you know what? The next woman, she's going to have my last name. And I mean, it's going to be on our honeymoon. And I took that vow. There was a group back in the day called True Love Waits. I don't even know if the group exists anymore. But it was about abstinence. And I'm gonna tell you something, I definitely co-sign on it, you know. And even though I wasn't a virgin when I got married, because I got married when I was 29, so almost 11 years ago. But the thing is, I waited 10 years after that. And let me tell you something, Lord knows it is hard. It is hard, okay? Because not a lot of people understand you. And especially in, you know, the United States. I mean, this society, you know, you think about it. You know, who are the people that, the celebs and the athletes that people look up to? I mean, they got multiple babies. I mean, look at that fool Lil Wayne. You know, I'm not hating on him. Even though he's, I guess you call him talented. You know, his music is catchy. But, seriously, he's got babies all over the place. And I mean, honestly, you bring a child into this world, the best thing you can do is be a father to that child. You know, to make sure that child is raised up the proper way. Not letting, you know, Xbox 360s, PS3s, whatever, raise them. Or let television babysit them. But no, being a father. And I had that example. You know, my parents, they're going on 41 years married. And I'm like, wow, you know, that's what I'm aiming for, you know. But going back to sex, you know, you always hear everyone's doing it. No, they're not. Not everyone's doing it. Even when I was at college, there was an 85% sexual activity rate. Yes, 85% of people on campus were getting busy, okay? They were getting it crunk. But you know what? I wasn't in that. Was it difficult? Absolutely. Because most of the women I met, even some of them that said they're Christians, they're like, eh, you know, cool. I like that. I like that you're not trying to get busy or anything. But then it's like, when you really don't, that makes them want you even more. Because you're much more of a challenge. You know? And I'm going to tell you something. Honestly, even when you're in high school, you may think, oh, everyone's doing it. Look, you know what? You're worth it. You're precious. Even if you're a dude, you know, you're an awesome person. And what you know, skills can just be real with you for a second. Look, what are the benefits of waiting, all right? Here's the thing. Let's talk about the drawbacks of not waiting. And then I'll hit you with the benefits of waiting, all right? First thing is getting busy, okay? Every time you have sex with a particular person, all right, you swap data, okay? Carnal knowledge, that's what it's called, okay? You don't understand what carnal knowledge is? Okay, it is carnal, which means your flesh. Your flesh has memories and tendencies. And the thing is, in the confines of a marriage, when you have sex with your partner, with your spouse, okay, your wife or your husband, what happens is you swap data, okay? There's a transmission of data between y'all, all right? What happens is you become one. People don't believe that, but it's very true. When I was at college, I could look at people when they first made it to school, see them after they got busy a few times, and those people actually started adopting similar tendencies to the person they were messing with. Plus, they started looking like each other. I promise you. I'm sitting up there like, that dude and that girl, they look alike. And sure enough, they were getting busy. You know, so that's the first thing. So, the woman I mess with, she never went to class. She was always on the phone, yapping and talking and everything. Me, I was trying my best to get to class, you know, really concerned and didn't really talk on the phone that much. But after we got busy a couple times and that data got transmitted, I mean, wow, it was almost like I was a different person, you know. Other thing is, all right, unless your parents just absolutely don't care or you're a grown person that doesn't have a roommate, chances are you're going to have to creep. You know, that's where the word comes for it. Like TLC, so I creep. Okay, what does creep mean? Creep means to sneak around, okay? Why should you sneak around, you know, to make love or have sex with your spouse? You don't have to. That is, unless you go to your parents' house and you're married and, you know, you don't want to get busy in your parents' house, but sometimes it happens, but still, you know. All right. The other thing, children out of wedlock. Look, a lot of people, they think that's where it's at. It's not. Seriously. The best thing you could do for that child is have a family structure in place. Now, look, I know I'm talking to a lot of people that are from single-parent homes. That's understandable. But moving forward, what you really, really, really want to pursue is a structured situation. You know? And another benefit, bruised emotions. Okay? Because, like, when you have sex, I mean, that is the deepest connection that two people can have versus a mother and a child. That's the only close. That's even closer because a woman's carrying a child for 9 months. But when you have sex with a person, you actually, like I said, with the becoming one part, but you are bonded. And when that bond is just suddenly broken, after a while, man, it becomes really hard. Your heart is broken. And your heart's a tender place. It really is. You know, you're talking about achievement unlocked, heartbroken. That's not a good place to be. You know, and I mean, it's so many other disadvantages. I mean, yep, okay, you know what? It feels good doing it. Yeah, but what about if the girl is caught up and she doesn't want to let go? Okay, there was a woman here in Houston who her husband was caught like in this love triangle between him, his jump off, and her. She ran over him in his Benz, backed up, ran over him again. Okay? One of my former classmates, Steve Air McNair, he was a quarterback with the Ravens, with the Titans, with the Oilers when he was here. You know, he had stepped away from the game, ended up meeting this young lady, very attractive woman. But he ended up meeting her, and she thought he was going to leave his wife and kids for her. But she was just a jump off. And I mean, any woman that's listening or dude that's listening that you're a part-time lover, let me explain something to you. Jump offs don't have benefits, okay? All you are is a piece of meat. That's it, okay? You don't have the last name. You don't even have the heart. All you have is their member, okay? That's it. But she thought, hey, I'm traveling with him. I'm going to be Mrs. McNair. He said, nah, baby girl, that's not how it works. So what did he do? What did she do? Next time he came over, bam, blew his brains out. And so he's laying there dead on the couch. She was thinking Romeo and Juliet. Okay, I'm going to kill myself. And then she had it, so she shot herself in the head and fell and was going to fall into his arms. Now, how jacked up is that? But let me tell you something, all right? You hit it good. I'm telling you right now. If you can really, really do it, you're going to have some women about to kill you, or men about to kill you over what? Foolishness? No, it ain't worth it. But now the benefits, okay? Benefits are is bonding, and especially in a marriage. Marriages work. It's tough. If someone tells you it's not, they cheating, okay? But really, with so many temptations out there and you're in a marriage, you need that bonding. You need unity. All right, when you and your wife are unified, you and your husband are unified, you're on one accord, okay? You operate, and what you do is you get more things accomplished than being divided and going two separate ways, all right? The other thing is, it really just teaches you about self-control. Yeah, everyone's doing it, but so what? You don't have to be, if everyone was jumping off a bridge, if everyone was smoking dope, you know, or crack, would you do it? No, have a mind of your own. Definitely. You know, and I mean, I'm pretty sure you came here looking for video games and I told you I was just going to be real with you and that's exactly what I'm doing. But the biggest thing is I just want to encourage you. You know what? There's nothing wrong with being a virgin. It's an awesome honor. And it's the only honor that you'll have only, you know, it's one of the few honors you have just once. You can't get it back once you get rid of it. Wear it as a badge of honor. Be proud that you're a virgin. You know, and if you're getting busy, if you're busy right now, you can stop. It will be difficult, trust me. Because the thing is, over the 10 years, oh, I got tried. I had a young lady tell me, hey, what would it take for me to make love to you tonight? And I said, girl, you'd have to marry me. She said, okay, can I marry you for a night? I'm done. But seriously, just wait. You're worth the wait. You know, don't worry about what your homies look. If your homies are saying, man, look at you. You're like 7-Up. Never had it, never will. You know how I know that? That's what they told me, okay? Don't worry about those fools. You know what? Get other running buddies. Don't worry about it. If you need encouragement, drop me a private message. It's all good to just be between you and me, alright? But seriously, you got an awesome gift. And plus, when you're on your honeymoon, when you're getting busy often, early often, you don't want to like look in the mirror and say, dang, I've done this so many times before. You know, you want to be special. And seriously, yeah, I'm cool. I'm the man. And yes, I do enjoy sex. Love it, okay? Wish I could put it in a bottle and walk around and have it, you know, like Powerade, you know, and just guzzle it. All day long. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie. Yes, up. And talking about, I love them comments from people like, man, that dude, like, he doesn't have sex. He doesn't, his wife and this and that. Y'all never even seen my wife, all right? Wife's gorgeous. I mean, she is extremely attractive. You may be like, and why is she with you? Look, it ain't about looks. It's never about looks. Me, I think I'm the most attractive man in the world. But, honestly, you know, hey. It's not about looks. It's about how a woman feels when she's with you. Okay? Doesn't matter about swagger. Doesn't matter about thug life. If a woman's with you because of that, let me tell you something. She's going to be gone when all that garbage is gone. But if you got a soldier, a true woman who loves you, let me tell you something, dude. You could lose your job, lose all your fortune. She's going to be right there with you. She's going to be like, you know what? I'll ride or die for you. Okay? That's a real woman. You know? So, and then lastly, the people that want, you know, that want to cheat, like, you may have married people that want to holler at you. Let me tell you something. You're looking at a preview of what's going to happen to you in a short amount of time because they're going to get tired. And they are insecure and they're looking for something. You can't fulfill that space in their heart. It's hurt. So, moral of this, PSA, this real talk, this let me be clear, just wait. It's worth it. Abstinence all the way. Don't worry about getting crunk. Don't go to Planned Parenthood. Don't try to, you know, if you got a baby on the way, be the best father you can, be the best mother you can, but learn from your mistake, you know. Don't give up the cookies. Don't give up the cookies. If you're a woman, boo, listen to me. Do not give up the cookies. Don't do that 30-day, that 60-day rule that Steve Harvey, that clown been married 3 times. What do he know about relationships, okay? So, and then, dudes, trust me. She may be hot. She may be the bomb, dude. I mean, like, dang, I can't believe I'm with her. Save it, okay? Trust me. Your honeymoon night, you're going to thank me. You will email me, dude. You were right, man. I'm telling you. Trust me on this, okay? You won't hear this coming from a lot of cats. But I'm telling you right now, right? Wait. Save yourself to marriage, okay? It is totally, 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 totally worth it. And I'm just being real with you, alright? So, I care about you. I don't want your emotions hurt over just absolute foolishness. And it's something that you can avoid. And you know what? Don't worry. You know, if you're wanting to get married, just wait. Just be patient. Enjoy getting your game on. Because your wife or husband may not be crazy about video games like you are. Enjoy it. Get your game on. You know. Do your best you can in school. Pursue your career. And you know what? Love will find y'all. Okay? Alright, anyway, it's your boy Skills. You know you can find me. Okay? So, and if you have any questions, if you just want to be real with me, one-on-one, you know, just message me. Like I said, all my info, ad is right here. It's going to be right below that, okay? So, hey, thank y'all so much for watching. If y'all did watch, y'all love it. If not, it's okay. But this is going to stay up here. And I'm not trying to hide it, not trying to unlist it or anything. I'm just being completely real with you, all right? Save yourself from marriage. You won't regret the decision. Trust me. All right. Anyway, it's your boy Skills. And yes, you know what? Yes. I got skills, okay? Seriously. I do. And I'm not just trying to toss, oh, look at me and everything. I listen to women. And, like, you know, one of my best friends in college was a woman, you know. And we're still kind of cool now. Like, my wife and her are really good friends. But the thing is, though, you know, I'm friends, you know, with my coworkers. I listen to what they got to say. And I'm telling you, you know, hearing them, hearing what they have to say and everything, trust me. Wait, it is worth it. Your wife will thank you. Your husband will thank you. Trust me. All right, love y'all. Talk to y'all later. Deuces.